Doc, help us understand, is the use of face shields effective in preventing the spread of the coronavirus?
We have very limited information or published information regarding the use of face shields. With regard to the general use of face shields, most of the studies indirectly answered that. And most of the studies are in healthcare setting, which shows a reduction in the transmission of COVID-19.
And Doc, why would that not be reliable enough for you, these studies that you mentioned, if these are taken in a healthcare setting?
Transmission of COVID depends on the context. So in healthcare setting, definitely the risk for acquiring COVID infection is higher, especially if you are dealing with or facing patients every day with COVID-19. So since most of the studies available now are done within the healthcare setting or with healthcare personnel doing community work, their risk will definitely be higher than the general public.
So is the government justified, Dr. Malundo, in actually relying on, I'm assuming they're relying on some studies, because if they're not relying on any study at all in imposing face shields, what could be their basis for imposing the requirement of using face shields?
First of all, we must understand the modes or the manner of transmission of COVID-19. So basically, COVID-19 is transmitted through inhalation of respiratory droplets and or aerosols from patients with COVID-19. It can also be transmitted via inoculation of these viral particles into the eyes, into the mouth, and into the nose. So other modes or possible causes or possible modes of transmission would be through fomites or through contaminated objects or surfaces. So in essence, face shield provides us eye protection and in a way prevents people from touching their face, such that there could be inoculation of the virus in these mucosal surfaces, such as the eyes, the nose, and the mouth.
But to your knowledge,
that's the theoretical basis for that.
Right.
Yes.
I understand, Doc. And to your knowledge, are there any other countries in the world requiring the use of face shields?
It's more of a specific to institutions or to hospitals or different settings. So there have been studies in India, in Bangladesh, and even in US, where when there's a high rates of community transmission, hospitals or community projects involving this involving healthcare personnel would be required to wear face shield.
But not in a general setting, like a general population, that like the one required here in the Philippines.
In terms of published studies, it's actually very difficult to conduct studies that would involve the community, especially in terms of infection control. You have to understand, or we have to understand, that conducting these studies are very difficult, sometimes not even feasible. So that's why most of the available studies are in healthcare setting.
Mm-hmm.
But in terms of transmission, there's a reduction in transmission of COVID-19 with the addition of face shield on top of the standard PPE or personal protective equipment.
All right. Now, Doc, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention in the United States did not recommend the wearing of face shields as substitute for wearing of masks, but it does recognize that there is added protection if you have protection for the eyes. Now, but from a policy standpoint, does the benefit of wearing face shields outweigh the cost?
When societies, medical societies, or even the government design or prepare guidelines in terms of infection control, it is not only the evidence or it is not only the published reports or evidence that is being considered. The context as to where these interventions will be done is also being considered. So in the formulation of the CTG for using face shield, even if there's very limited information, I think they have leaned on the side of safety. In our current situation in the country, where especially in Metro Manila, where the rates of community transmission is high, and adding another layer of protection is, I think, a necessary thing that they wanted to provide another layer of protection for Filipinos.
Mm-hmm. Now, proponents of face shields, Doc, say that they help prevent those wearing them from touching the face. But, you know, in a country like the Philippines, you know, the temperatures here, it also adds to the heat. When you perspire, that also forces you to take off your face shield and wipe your face. So on this point, particular point, doesn't this defeat the purpose?
Of course, that's a valid point. However, given the limited, again, information that we have, I think we are taking the side of safety, of actually recommending the use of face shield in our current pandemic. In the current pandemic, especially with the surge that we have experienced last March, face shield is among the recommended PPE to be used. And despite this intervention and all other standard PPE that we are already using, we have experienced a surge that is that have caused a great burden, especially to our healthcare setting. And if we will remove this additional protection, I am not sure what will happen to the number of cases. It can increase, it cannot increase, or it may be stable, but we cannot predict whatever may happen. So I think in this, at this time, it will be safer to use or recommend face shield while vaccine coverage is still low. And also, physical distancing cannot be guaranteed at all times.
Mm-hmm. Doc, what about the environmental impact of thousands of disposable plastic sheets? You know, this is also a concern for disposable masks, but there's no doubt masks work. So on face shields, at least, is this worth the environmental impact?
Of course, use of plastics, if not properly disposed, will have a great impact into the environment. That's why reusable face shields are recommended. We have that available in the market. So we can actually use reusable face masks. They have just to be cleaned or disinfected after every use.
That's one
way of reducing the environmental impact of this face shield.
Mm-hmm. All right. Thank you for joining us this morning, Dr. Malundo. Appreciate your insights.
Thank you.